You're watching NET Television.
Sports programming on NET is made possible by a gift from Harold and Marian Anderson, recognizing the importance of high school and college athletics in Nebraska.
Sports, Nebraska's home for sports, is live from the Bob Devaney Sports Center in Lincoln, Nebraska for the 2011 NSAA Girls Basketball Tournament. And tonight, in the Class C1 State Championship Final, it's the Hastings St. Cecilia Hawkettes taking on the Wahoo Warriors. And hello again, everybody. I'm Larry Putney, along with former prep star Trudy Nolan. Matt Schick will be joining us in just a moment, but we wrap up the day in Class C1 with a terrific showdown between a team that's been here before and a team that is a newcomer to this environment. Let's talk about that newcomer first, Hastings St. Cecilia, and the road they took to get here, knocking off Sandy Creek, which I think was a shock to just about everybody.
It was. You know, they played a great game. They shot very well yesterday. They have balanced scoring. They run the floor very well. They have sisters, the Farmer sisters. They combined yesterday for 40 points in that semifinal game.
Wahoo Warriors, meanwhile, come in led by Linda Walker, the former Linda Schnitzler. They're 27-1. They know what it's like to be down here as well.
Yeah, they do. They were here last year. They were runner-up, actually. So you know that they're back. They're hungry for that championship game. You'll see some pressure defense from Wahoo. They also have sisters. They have the Mern sisters. And yesterday, those Mern sisters, they combined for 35 points in the semifinal. So here we are, Larry, back at the game with sisters on both sides again tonight.
Should be a good one. Wahoo Warriors take on Hastings St. Cecilia. The Class C1 State Championship coming up next.
From your Nebraska Department of Roads.
Animal agriculture is vital to Nebraska. Livestock production not only contributes to our food supply, but also helps our rural communities. Livestock provides revenue for schools, creates jobs, supports Main Street, and enhances the future for farm families. The Nebraska Soybean Board's Animal Agriculture Initiative works to encourage growth of responsible livestock enterprises to benefit agriculture and Nebraska.
Back to the Bob Devaney Sports Center for the NSAA Class C1 Girls State High School Basketball Tournament. I am Matt Schick. This is it, the sixth of six state championships to be handed out today. It is Wahoo, it is Hastings St. Cecilia. Let's send it over to public address announcer Rich Broders.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Nebraska School Activities Association, its member schools, and U.S. Bank, welcome to the Bob Devaney Sports Center for tonight's Class C1 Girls Championship game between the 21-4 Hastings St. Cecilia Hawkettes and the 27-1 Wahoo Warriors. Now let's meet the teams. First, the non-starters for Hastings St. Cecilia. Number 2, Libby Kissinger. Number 4, Chanel Farmer. Number 11, Sarah Gettert. Number 12, Jamie Williams. Number 14, Morgan Nicola. Number 20, Alyssa Schrupp. And number 22, Olivia Thomas. And now the non-starters for Wahoo. Number 11, Sydney Hancock. Number 13, Darcy Berry. number 31, Morgan Hancock. Number 35, Jessica Berry. Number 41, Sam Granginet. Number 43, Caitlin O'Brien. And number 45, Lois White. And now, here's a starting lineup for the Hawkettes of Hastings St. Cecilia High School. A 5'4 senior, number one, Abby Jackson. A 5'4 senior, number three, Charisse Farmer. A 5'8 senior, number five, Lexi Schmidt. A 5'7 senior, number 10, Tessa Kalupa. And a 5'11 junior, number 15, Caitlin Ernst. The assistant coaches for the Hawkettes are P.J. Henry, Josh Noose, and John Jackson. And the head coach for Hastings St. Cecilia, John Kyle. And now, here's a starting lineup for the Warriors of Wahoo High School. A 5'6 senior, number 15, Maddie Mern. A 5'7 junior, number 21, Sadie Mern. A 5'4 senior, number 23, Aaron Walker. A 5'8 senior, number 25, Kayla Bennett. And a 5'9 senior, number 33, Emily Brodahl. The assistant coaches for the Warriors are Wes Kramer and Michelle Wilt. And the head coach for Wahoo, Linda Walker. The officials for tonight's Class C1 championship game are Jeff Beller, Andrew Carlson, and Greg Warnicki. The bench official is Mr. Brett Swanson. With branches located throughout Nebraska, U.S. Bank is pleased to be the premier partner of the Nebraska School Activities
Association. So we're back at the Bob Devaney Sports Center with the Wahoo Warriors taking on Hastings St. Cecilia. Obviously, St. Cecilia located in Hastings, right along I-80, just south of, and then Wahoo, just north of Lincoln by about 20 minutes or so. And Wahoo back in the state championship match for the second year in a row. St. Cecilia in the state title game for the first time since 1982. Should be a good one. Wahoo getting to this state championship match by knocking off Norfolk Catholic and Minden. Hastings St. Cecilia, as we said earlier, took out Ashland Greenwood and then upset Sandy Creek rather handily, 78-65 in the semifinal. So that's how Wahoo and St. Cecilia got here. And we are ready for our final state championship of the day. This concludes six straight state championships. We've crowned five and a sixth yet to be determined. Tip won by Wahoo. Right off the bat, Wahoo fires in a three. Made Maddie Mern puts it down. Well, Maddie Mern averages 18 on the year per game and comes out firing, reminiscent of what Seward did earlier tonight. Down low, spin move in the lane, can't get it to go. Rebound brought out by Sadie Mern. So the sister, Sadie and Maddie Mern. One a senior, one a junior.
Sadie's coming off of an injury she had earlier. She had an ankle injury in early February. She did play in the district final, but you can see every once in a while she'll tweak it just a little bit, but you know what? She's a tough girl.
Maddie with another bucket. Make it 5-0, three-pointer on the way off the back. Rebound by Sadie. Sadie will push it up the floor, pushes it outside of Walker. Doesn't get the roll, tipped around, way out in front. There's Kalupa. Tessa Kalupa doesn't make lay-in. And push the other way. Frenetic pace to start. One more time, we'll go Walker. Pulls it back down. And now driving the lane, uses the glass. Good shot, Emily Brodahl. So Brodahl with the bucket, and out quick is Wahoo, 7-0. St. Cecilia getting good looks, just has not been able to convert on the buckets. This pressure defense, you'll see it throughout from Wahoo. Shot. Lexi Schmidt puts it in. So St. Cecilia now on the board. Dribble by Mern. Nice pass. Mern, good looking player. Outside, Mern with a three-pointer. So Maddie Mern. 8 points for Wahoo. Maddie Mern, 10 for Wahoo. Maddie Mern has 8 of them. 2 3-pointers and a deuce. A foul called on the drive. That'll be called on Emily Brodahl. There's a look at John Kyle in his 11th year at St. Cecilia. 133-82 career record. Coached the boys at Lawrence for 1 year before going to St. Cecilia and leading up this Hawkette program. Free throw rolls in there for Charisse Farmer. And there's a look at Linda Walker, the former Linda Schnitzler, her father Bob Schnitzler. She's 21st year at Wahoo, 14th as the head coach. She's 197-108. Took that program and has really turned it around. Of course, Linda's father Bob at one point was the all-time winningest coach, football coach in the Nebraska history, and won a few state championships. And Linda was playing basketball for Battle Creek as well. So 10-4, hustling back down, and stealing that away was Walker. Other way, Mern can't get it done. Mern again puts the pressure on, and a foul called on Maddie Mern.
You know, and Wahoo is going to play that pressure defense, and they want to play full court pressure because they want to get Hastings St. Cecilia from running up the floor, because that's what they like to do. They like to run that ball up, get those easy shots from there.
So 10-4. Shot is off, rebound by Walker. Walker will push it up the floor. Hard to the basket, but a travel. So 10-4, Wahoo out quick. Schmidt with the ball. Over to Chanel Farmer. Back to Schmidt. Fakes the shot. Gets it off. Banks off the back of the rim. And now Sadie Mern brings it down. And there has not been a trip down the floor where Wahoo has not absolutely pushed the ball as fast as they could and as hard as they could.
It's a fast tempo game right now. You know, we talked about 3 days down here in Lincoln, and they are going up and down the floor right now.
Jackson now with it, kicks it over to Schmidt. Lexi should make it Farmer. Chanel Farmer was off. So pace slowing a bit now, 10-4. Firing from deep, rattles around, off the hands, and Hastings St. Cecilia will keep it. So into the game for Wahoo is Morgan Hancock. Going to the bench is Emily Brodahl. Good by Chanel Farmer. Farmer came off the bench in the semifinals to finish second in scoring on the team, and Farmer puts up that three-pointer there and pulls it back to within three. Mern off her foot. Nope, they're going to say it was off of St. Cecilia. It'll stay with Wahoo.
Wahoo comes into the game at 27-1, and their one loss is to Seward, who we just crowned
That's
in the
right.
Class B Championships.
Good
that
move.
Was in early December, Larry.
So good move in the paint. And these two teams have actually played each other, not during the year, but during the summer. Both of these went to the team summer camp in Minden, and they squared off against each other. So both coaches commented after their semifinal wins, both John Kyle and Linda Walker, that they think they know each other pretty well. They know what they're capable of. They've seen each other. That summer team camp really gave both a pretty good picture of what to expect. Good shot and the bucket.
That man-to-man pressure defense. Hastings St. Cecilia running those flex cuts there on the offense. Good back cut.
So Mern brings it up the floor. Sadie Mern tracks it down and travels. So 11-9 here. And a timeout on the floor. NET Sports is your ticket to exciting sports action right in your living room. You can help us deliver inspiring sports programming by joining the NET Sports Partners Club. Your contribution helps to ensure that your favorite sports programs continue for years to come. And you'll receive some great thank you gifts with NET's appreciation for your support. You can log on to netnebraska.org/sportspartners and become a member today. Interesting story on that Wahoo squad, number 31, who you see right there, Morgan Hancock. She's getting a full ride scholarship to USD. Actually tore her ACL during the semifinals last year in state softball. Continued to play in the title game. Her parents didn't tell anybody. She had torn her ACL. Hit a home run in the championship game with a torn ACL. Team went on to win the state title, so she had to have surgery after the season. She missed the entire basketball season because of that surgery. And Trudy, she came back to practice this week on Monday, her first day back. So if you look at her stat sheet, she's got zero stats across. You think this is somebody who doesn't play. She was a starter last year, a valuable contributor, and she just came back to the floor on Monday and has played in her first games at state. That's Morgan Hancock, number 31, the 5'9 senior forward. So nothing like knocking off the rust at the state tournament.
That is the dedication of these players. You know, there she is, working hard out there, going after that as she shot the ball. She's going after that person as a defender.
Foul on the shot. Erin Walker. Erin Walker, another great story as you take a look at Walker on the hand. Shot is off, but Erin Walker, number 23, hoping for an appointment to the Naval Academy. She has been nominated, waiting to hear on that appointment. Otherwise, she will likely play at the next level at either Morningside or Briar Cliff, who are both recruiting her, both schools in Sioux City, Iowa. And the rebound kicks out and to Kalupa. The Farmer with it. Over to Jackson, and now Kalupa again. Jackson looks inside. Kalupa dribbles into the middle. Skip pass over to Farmer. Farmer missed the shot. And a foul will be called on Schmidt. Lexi Schmidt over the back on the attempted rebound. Saw Lexi Schmidt with her first foul.
You know, I strange to look at these teams. We've got a lot of rich tradition. We've talked about Howells having that rich tradition of winning. We got Seward in the last game. Actually, both of these teams, you know, you look at Hastings St. Cecilia, they've had 12 state trips here in basketball. A lot of them in the earlier years, but they were here last year also. So a lot of rich tradition in basketball coming in these teams here in the state finals.
St. Cecilia won three state championships in 77, 78, and 79. They were state runner-up in 82 and haven't been back to the title game since. They've been at state for 4 years under John Kyle, just haven't made it this far. Kind of a rebuilding process for St. Cecilia under John Kyle. Made the district final in 6 of the last 8 years, and this is the first year they were able to break through and win that district title. So big, sometimes those seemingly little steps can be very big in a mindset of your program and players. Back into the game is Libby Kissinger, 5'5 junior guard. Farmer will take a rest. Kissinger with the ball. Now to Jackson, back to Kissinger. Looks inside. Tries to find Schmidt. Lexi Schmidt with it now. Out of the corner. Shot on its way off the front by Jackson. The rebound put back, not good. Rebound again. Nice offensive rebounds. Make another shot inside. Kick back out. Shot by Farmer. Can't get it again. And that time, a foul called on Morgan Nicola. Morgan Nicola, a freshman, 5'11 forward. So nearing the end of period number one, a very quick first period. Can't get the shot off before the buzzer. No shot. So after one period of play, it's Wahoo on top of St. Cecilia, 11-9. They're playing for the C1 state title. We'll be back in Lincoln in just a moment.
We'd like to say we have the good life in our state. And for more than 40 years, Nebraska Public Power District has kept the good life running smoothly for Nebraskans. We are driven to go above and beyond with a spirit to provide reliable, affordable electricity with outstanding customer service each and every day. Because in the end, we want to make the good life better for all. Nebraska Public Power District, always there when you need us.
Time Warner Cable is dedicated to the future of our nation's children. That's why we've launched our Connect a Million Minds initiative. We're asking adults to help us inspire kids through science, technology, engineering, and math. And we're achieving this through local partnerships with FIRST. Across the country, Time Warner Cable employees are helping bring FIRST robotics competitions to the areas we serve. The future of our nation and our children depends on math, science, and technology. Visit connectamillionminds.com to find out what you can do.
Welcome back to the Bob Devaney Sports Center, the Class C1 State Championship, along with Trudy Nolan, Matt Schick. I'm Larry Putney. Great to have you with us as we wrap up our day-long coverage of Girls State High School Championships, sponsored by the NSAA. Five champions already crowned, and waiting to crown one more here in Class C1, either St. Cecilia or Wahoo. 11-9 Wahoo. Warriors opened up a big lead in that early in that first period, 7-0. Since then, it's been a St. Cecilia 7-1 run since the 5:40 mark of that first period.
You know, at the end of the first quarter, St. Cecilia is out-rebounding Wahoo, and a lot of those are coming off of the offensive end where they're getting those putbacks. They just aren't falling at that time.
Sadie with the ball, now to Maddie. Maddie Mern, three-pointer on the way, just off. I like the way she follows her shot. You can almost see every time when, a lot of times responsibility dictates they can't if they have to get back. But She clearly is free to chase that rebound and follows her shot all the time.
You can tell, you know, you can tell both teams are really taught the fundamentals of shooting, of checking out, playing pressure defense, all those different kinds of things that winning programs need to have.
Good bounce pass inside, the shot by Ernst. And Ernst was fouled, so Kate Ernst will go to the line. 6 foot junior center.
Here it is, you know, she gets a quick shot off right there just in time so she can get that foul so she can go to the free throw line.
First free throw comes up a little short. Into the game, Katie O'Brien for the Wahoo Warriors. Here's Kate's second shot. Rattles around off the front of the rim. Sadie pushes it off to sister Maddie. Kick back out, off. Rebound goes long, chase for it. Good hustle by Farmer to try to keep it in, but it goes off Sharice Farmer and out.
You know, we talk about Wahoo with their one loss to Seward. Hastings St. Cecilia and their four losses. Three of those four losses are teams that we saw here at the state tournament. Sandy Creek, Aquinas Catholic, and Sutton. All those teams qualifying here at the state tournament.
Sadie, three-pointer is off. Nice rebound by Ernst. Pushed up the floor by Farmer. Down 11-9. No score yet here in the second period until right there. So Ernst with the bucket ties it at 11, our first tie since it was 0-0. Sadie right back down, dishes off, the shot by Walker is off. And now St. Cecilia looking for its first lead of the game. Down to Schmidt. Back into the game, Morgan Nicola, as well as Abby Jackson, number one. Even at 11. Sadie Mern will bring it up. Off to Maddie Mern, fires away the three and got it. So three threes here in this first half for Maddie Mern.
You know, it's a good connection when Sadie, one of the sisters, Sadie, bringing the ball up, doing a nice job handling it, kicking it out to the other sister as she's shooting those threes out there.
Drive by Farmer, pretty scoop shot by Farmer. 14-13. Well, Sadie very adept at handling the ball. Good pass underneath. Three on the way, that's off. Rebound goes long. Chased it out off of Kalupa. So it will stay with Wahoo. Good hustle by Kalupa.
Sadie does a nice job of seeing the floor. You know, she's attacking the basket hard, but yet she's looking up, she's seeing who she can pass to there. And even in, you know, the condition that she is with her ankle, she's not slowing down any, not at all.
Aaron Walker now with it. Long shot by Sadie. Had to give her a couple of points just for the effort.
Could not do that again if she tried 10 times.
So 14-13 Wahoo. 4:20 here in this second period of play. Dish outside to Schmidt. Schmidt hits it. So as St. Cecilia with its first lead of the game at 15-14.
St. Cecilia likes to run the floor quickly, but they also like to, if they have to get set in their offense, they'd like to drive in, look for the kick back out.
Good drive, but off. And the shot by O'Brien, pushed again. Here's Jackson. Jackson pulls up for three, just short. Right on line by Jackson, but comes up a little short. Another three on the way. That one rattles out. Rebound to O'Brien. No shot. Foul on the floor. Well, now back into the game for St. Cecilia, Kissinger, as well as Caitlin Ernst. Put on the floor. Hancock takes it back up top. Drive by Hancock, blocked and a foul. So Hancock scored her first points of the year in the second round, I believe, of the tournament.
There she is. We've seen those drives all day long by different teams and taking it in there real nice, looking for that free throw on that foul on there so she can get to a free throw line.
So now Morgan Hancock, 5'9 senior. Seeing her first action of the year here at the state tournament. You see the big knee brace from that knee injury. It was the first game here at state where she actually scored her first points. She scored four total. That goes off the toe and over and back, called on St. Cecilia.
No, it's good hustle getting on the floor there. And as you watch Sadie Mern, that's what she does. She's all over the floor, diving on the floor after balls, going after steals everywhere that she can.
Great effort trying to get the shot off was Maddie Mern. Out of bounds off of the Hawkettes. So it'll stay with the Warriors. Right in the middle, quick shot, a little short. Kick back out. Back to Walker. Just off with the three. And out. Tipped out by St. Cecilia. So once again, it will stay with the Wahoo Warriors. All even at 15 here. 2.5 left before halftime. Nice drive. Hancock. Right through traffic and then the turnover. Right back to Sadie. Keeps the dribble back to Maddie. And a foul call. One more look at it.
Maddie holding on to the ball real strong there. Girl reaching in on her as she holds the ball real strong in her hands.
Hancock with it up top. Here's O'Brien. O'Brien ball tipped away. And Kissinger ahead to Farmer. And the foul on Sadie Mern. Sadie Mern getting several Division I looks. Some D1 coaches at the first practice of the year to take a look at the junior from Wahoo. Big Ten schools among those, looking at Sadie Mern. Mern drives and the foul. Mern just has one speed and it's full speed ahead.
It is. As you can look at her coming down the floor here, she's got that determination that she is going to go all the way into that basket. But again, that's on defense also. She is all over the floor. She's a hard worker out here.
That rattles in. Look at Linda Walker, 21st year at Wahoo, 14th as the head coach. She was a standout player herself at Battle Creek and Wayne State College. Boy, good dish. Good. Jackson chases it down. Farmer will drive in. Good dish and the foul on Mern. A second foul on Sadie Mern.
It's a good look inside there. She takes it in. Again, Sadie Mern hustling down the floor.
That is good. Lexi Schmidt with the second one, also good. That'll cut that lead to two at 19-17. Morgan Nicola back into the game. She'll come in for Lexi Schmidt. Farmer will shadow Walker up the floor. They try to trap her. Walker keeps the ball. Inside. Hancock can't get it, put right back up. And a foul called. Foul on the arm of Abby Jackson picking up the foul. That'll put Kate O'Brien at the line.
So we look at things here the first half. Everything is pretty even. You know, the score has been pretty close the whole time. Even when you look at rebounds, you look at turnovers, you look at shooting percent. It's a good even match here in this Class C1 championship so far.
So 19-17, St. Cecilia trying to tie it up or take the lead with that three-pointer. Abby Jackson buries the three. And now a one-point advantage back for St. Cecilia. Fouling Walker on the drive. That'll put Walker at the line for two. First one in and out. Back into the game comes Kissinger.
The one thing Hastings St. Cecilia, you know, they like to run the floor, but they are able to substitute girls in and out. Sometimes when you look, those Hastings St. Cecilia girls look like they could just go forever. They work hard, but yet they don't look like they're that tired.
With 20 seconds left, to steal by O'Brien. She goes in for the layup and got it. O'Brien puts Wahoo up by two. Now inside 15, Jackson with it. She's a threat from three-point range. 7 seconds left, Farmer drives the baseline, pulls it back out, shot on the way. Nicola got it. And fitting, we end the first half all even at 22. We've got a good one to end the day here in Class C1. St. Cecilia trailed big early, but came back and tied it up at 22. Wahoo started out on fire, 4 of 5 from the floor. Since then, 3 of 20. Started out shooting 4 of 5, and now 3 for 20. Let's go down to Matt Schick, who is with St. Cecilia coach John Kyle.
Yes, thank you, Larry. Coach Kyle, Wahoo, as Larry said, started off pretty hot. How were you able to cool them off?
Well, they had a nice run there at the start of the half, and I told the girls they're not going to keep shooting like that. They shot the ball extremely well, and we settled into our defense and got some offense going, and it's a good game at 22 apiece.
What adjustments do you need to make in the second half, if any?
Well, I think we need to just be calm down a little bit. You know, the excitement of the big game is got us a little rattled here and there, but I think if we settle in, you know, on both ends of the floor, I think we're going to be fine. Our bench is doing well. You know, we just have to go out there and execute plays.
Thanks for the time, Coach.
Thank you much.
All right, thanks very much, Matt. We are at halftime of the Class C1 State Championship. All even at 22, St. Cecilia and the Warriors of Wahoo.
A flame burns brightly in these young Nebraskans. It's the energy of enterprise and entrepreneurship, a passion for learning and leadership, responsibility and respect. At One Oak, we see that flame, and in it we see Nebraska's future. That's why we support 4-H and FFA in the counties we serve, because we want to keep their flame burning always. Natural gas from One Oak Energy Marketing, the one in energy.
Students, do you know what's in demand? You are. Your knowledge, energy, and skills are all in demand. And so are many rewarding and exciting jobs in the electric utility industry. Visit bnppd.com and talk with your teachers and guidance counselors. They can help you find the right college or university to study an energy career or the right apprentice program to gain skills and experience. Tap into your internal energy and see how far you can go.
NET Sports coverage of the 2011 NSAA State Basketball Tournament is brought to you in part by Time Warner Cable, inspiring young people to build the skills they need in science, technology, engineering, and math to become the problem solvers of tomorrow. By the Nebraska Soybean Board, encouraging the use of renewable biodiesel fuels for a healthier environment. For information, NebraskaSoybeans.org. And by the Nebraska Corn Board and Nebraska's corn farmers, growing more with less through sustaining innovation at NebraskaCorn.org. And by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Nebraska, one less thing to worry about.
We're all knotted up at 22 between Wahoo and Hastings St. Cecilia here in the Class C1 NSAA State Basketball Championships. Please be joined by Darren Boyson, NSAA Assistant Director and in charge of the wrestling championships for the 42nd year NET broadcast those championships. Another great event for you guys.
It really was. It was a great year. We had some challenges to start with Creighton basketball game, but you know, the Quest staff is really great. We've got great floor managers, so kind of pulled an all-nighter to start with, but it really worked out well this year.
You guys also had a new format for 10 mats Thursday and Friday. Used to be 8. What were the challenges with those extra mats and more people helping out, I know?
Well, we started rolling them out a little after midnight and got done about 5:30. So it really worked well. Our goal was to not have the kids come in quite as early, and we'd hopefully get them out of there a little sooner. And in the end, it saved us about 2 hours each day. So I think the fans can appreciate that, and the athletes and coaches.
You guys also experimented a little bit with predetermined mat assignments. How did that work?
Well, I think the jury's a little bit out on that. We're surveying the coaches right now. We want to do what the member schools want, so we tried to determine that. I think the media really liked it, but in the end, we want the member schools to do what they want there.
And you also added a new area for press row. People like me, very thrilled with that.
I think the press row, they really like that. It's probably larger than I even imagined, so I think that was a good deal for them.
And talk about the different class races, always competitive. You saw a longtime champion get unseated.
You know, it was a really good year for team competitions. In Class A, Grand Island won their third straight championship. As you mentioned, Omaha Scout was knocked off in Class B for the first time in 13 years by Central City. In Class C, Wood River won for the first time their state championship since 1971. And in Class D, it was Amherst winning their second championship in a row. So really good competition this year.
Any changes next year you envision?
Well, I think we found some things we like this year, but we want to try to do what the coaches and the schools want.
It's at Quest Center next year once again. Darren, thanks a lot.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Halftime here, Hastings St. Cecilia and Wahoo tied at 22 in the Class C1 NSAA Girls State Basketball Championship.
Two, three, six. This isn't Madison Square Garden. These drills probably won't make anyone a number one draft pick. But these players are practicing for something important. While they work on their jump shots, they're also learning teamwork, discipline, self-confidence, how to deal with wins and losses. Skills that will make them winners long after they leave the court. Support high school activities in your community. Because when kids take part, they get set for life.
A diesel-powered engine on a farm works hard and operates in a grueling environment. Soy biodiesel fuels stand up to the challenge of powering farm equipment, but are also renewable and environmentally responsible as well. The Nebraska Soybean Board is committed to encouraging the use of soy biodiesel to protect the environment and sustain Nebraska's agriculture. The Nebraska Soybean Checkoff, growing opportunity from the ground up.
From your Nebraska Department of Roads.
I just wanna be okay, be okay, be okay. I just wanna be okay today. I just wanna be okay, be okay, be okay. I just wanna be okay today. I just wanna feel today, feel today, feel today. I just wanna feel something today. I just wanna be okay, be okay. Okay, I just wanna be okay today.
So welcome back to the Bob Devaney Sports Center. Still at halftime, all even at 22 in the Class C1 State Championship Showdown between St. Cecilia and the Wahoo Warriors. As the teams return to the floor, we wanna take you back and give you a look at some highlights from the first half action. Wahoo really got out quick and started earlier, but St. Cecilia fought its way back into it. And here's a shot by Schmidt that goes down.
They did, and here's a good cut, a good pass in there. Good shot by Farmer. And then that long three, that's way behind the white three-point marker on the floor by Jackson. Wahoo, there's a sister-to-sister, that's Sadie to Maddie, and nice look inside. And here's Maddie, a nice three-point shot. And then right before half, we have a great steal by O'Brien as she takes it down and puts a layup, puts a shot in for a layup there.
That made it 22-20. Let's go to Matt Schick, who's with head coach Linda Walker.
Thank you, Larry. Coach Walker, what was your message to your troops at halftime?
I just told them that we really needed to settle down and relax. You know, we're a little tight right now. The baskets, the shots just are not falling for us, and we just need to take care of the ball. We need to execute our offense, and we need to start pounding the ball inside and try to get some high percentage shots.
Because things were really working for you early on for your first five shots, and then you did cool off a little bit.
Yeah, we did cool off after that and went a little bit cold. And Hastings, they are coming at us hard, and we just were not playing very good, solid defense against them. We're going to have to do a better job the second half.
16 minutes to go. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Larry.
All right, thanks, Matt, and thanks to Linda Walker. So let's take a look at the statistics from that first half, and you see a fairly even story across the field goal shooting a little bit better for the Hawkettes, but your three-point field goal, both teams shooting 25%, one more for Wahoo.
We really do. Things are pretty even, you know. Yep. As you said, Larry, a little bit of difference there in the field goal percent, but even as you look at rebounds, turnovers, all those different kinds of things.
Yep.
I mean, that's why we're here at halftime with a 22-22 game right now. We got an even match going on here.
It's all even at 22 between Hastings, St. Cecilia, and the Warriors of Wahoo. When we come back, second half coming your way.
You know, many years ago, when I was about 8 years old, I got the opportunity to watch a box turtle behind my house lay her eggs. And watching that turtle go through all that effort, it just piqued my curiosity, and I wanted to learn more and read more. My entire job is science. I want children to get connected with science and utilize the technology and the engineering abilities, because each one of us has the ability to change the world.
To find out what you can do to inspire a young person, visit connectamillionminds.com.
95% of American corn farms are family-owned.
Farmers grow 70% more corn per ounce of fertilizer than just 35 years ago.
The energy to grow a bushel of corn has dropped by 37% over the past 30 years.
Farmers have cut soil erosion by 44% through new tillage methods.
This is sustaining innovation, and it's how Nebraska corn farmers are growing more with less. On the web at NebraskaCorn.org.
NET Sports coverage of the 2011 NSAA State Basketball Tournament is brought to you in part by One Oak Energy Marketing, supporting 4-H and FFA in the Nebraska counties we serve, at OneOakEnergyMarketing.com. By the U.S. Marines, the few, the proud, the Marines. More information at Marines.com. By Time Warner Cable, inspiring young people to build the skills they need in science, technology, engineering, and math to become the problem solvers of tomorrow. And by the Nebraska Public Power District, applauding the dedication, teamwork, and sportsmanship of Nebraska's high school athletes. So back at the Devaney Sports Center, getting set for the third period of action between Hastings St. Cecilia and the Wahoo Warriors. Both teams making buckets right there at the end of that third period to even the score at 22.
Yeah, you know, we saw in the highlights where O'Brien made a great steal for Wahoo to put that in, but also right before half, we had a freshman step up there and Nicola and make a big basket there to send them into the halftime all tied up.
Last year, the Warriors of Wahoo in this position. They were the runner-up last year in Class C1, losing in overtime.
You know, I think as you hear Coach Walker come out, you can almost hear her dad in those same words that she's right. saying. Execute, inside, solid defense, and just settle down. You know, you can almost hear him saying those exact words.
Good rebound by Walker, takes it back up top. Good pass down low. A little strong with the shot, picked up, and St. Cecilia now running. Farmer with it, back up top to Jackson. Over to Kalupa. Kalupa goes inside, and the foul down low. Foul will be called on Murren, Maddie Murren. Second foul on Murren, who's leading Wahoo with 11 points. And all 11 of those coming early on three-pointers. He's 3-for-5 from three-point range. So St. Cecilia takes the early lead here in the third, 24-22. All tipped away, great hustle to get after it. Saved into Wahoo. And a timeout called by Linda Walker.
30-second timeout, Wahoo. That's our second and final 30-second
timeout. So you can join us 1 week from today as NET Sports presents the 2011 NSAA Boys State Basketball Tournament. It'll be right back here at the Bob Devaney Sports Center. We'll bring you all of the action live throughout the day, and it will be brought to you in beautiful high def. And don't forget, you can also watch this year's NSAA high school basketball tournaments right here exclusively on NET television, because we are Nebraska's home for sports. A tip to buzzer coverage from the First State Championship bright and early at 9 in the morning until the last one finishes somewhere around 11 o'clock at night. A minute gone here in the second half of play. Walker, open shot, rattles off, put right back up off the glass, couldn't get it. Rebound. 3-point shot on the way, got it. 4 3-pointers now for Murren. And she leads with 14 points, 4 of 6 from 3-point range for Maddie Murren.
I suppose that Sadie has a few things to say to her, but remember, I have assists because I'm the one passing it to you.
Outside, Jackson with the three-pointer. She's got it. Jackson's got a sweet little jumper from long range, and she is now 2 of 4 from outside and 6 points. Both of all four, 6 of her points coming on the three-pointer, and back at it again, another three.
Well, we are getting that three-point line going here again on this game, just like we did in the last one against Seward and Elkhorn.
28-27 Wahoo on top after the three. Ernst looks inside, kicks it back up top. Drive goes Kalupa. And now the 3-on-2 break. Kick outside, right back inside. Good dish. Mern to Mern.
And as you can tell, I think they must get along pretty good out here. They're giving each other that eye, you know, pointing at each other. They're excited. They're leading their team here. You know, right now, Wahoo's ahead 30-27.
30-27, 5 minutes. And we have a substitution. Back into the game comes Libby Kissinger, along with Morgan Nicola into the game for St. Cecilia. So 3-point lead by Wahoo. Mern off the walker, drives, and the lay-in. Make it Caleb Bennett with the lay-in. Nice drive by Bennett off glass. Foul called. It'll be called on 23, Aaron Walker. Up top to Kissinger. Now Jackson. Jackson looks inside. Schmidt trying to post up. Skip pass across. Back in the paint. Nicola. Nicola puts it down. So Nicola with the bucket. Pulls back to within three at 32-29. Mern brings it up the floor. Great pass by Mern inside, and the foul called on Lexi Schmidt.
That was a great pass by Mern there. Abby Jackson from Hastings St. Cecilia giving that pressure, though, on Mern. She's making her work to bring that ball up the floor. Mern, though, keeping her eyes up. She sees the floor so well as she's dribbling up.
...33-29, trying to extend it back to five. On the way from Bennett, rattles in. So Bennett hits both of them, makes it a 5-point game at 34-29. Midway through this third period. Last C1 state championship, St. Cecilia and Wahoo. Lost momentarily by Ernst, but regathered by Nicola. Skip pass across, Farmer thought about the three. Drives the lane, puts up the shot, and gets the roll. Good drive by Sharice Farmer. And a nice try to save it on the inbounds pass after the pressure. John Kyle wanted that call about as bad as anyone in the building. And let everybody know it.
Right now, when you're in this position, second half of the championship game, you want to get anything that That's is right. possible.
3-point lead with the ball. Right back in the paint, Walker got it.
Aaron Walker.
Nice drive of the bucket by Farmer. Mern keeps those eyes up, looking down the floor. Mern with the shot is off, rebound. Bennett right back to Walker in the paint. Walker is hacked by Kissinger. So
So that'll put Walker at the line and try to extend that lead.
You know, we've talked about sisters here in the state tournament. Right now on the floor, we have both the Farmer sisters on the floor right now, as they combined yesterday for 40 points, as we mentioned.
Yeah.
We also have the Mern sisters on the floor, you know, as they combined for quite a few points as well. So a lot of family traditions going on here on these two teams.
Shot good by Walker. Extends it back to five. Schmidt with it, skip pass over to Farmer. Now to Jackson. Kissinger drives into the paint, kicks it back to Jackson, thought about the three. Guarded by Walker, now drives the lane. And a foul on Walker. Nope, they're gonna call it on 31 instead. It'll go on Morgan Hancock, not on Walker, so Hancock with the foul. Well, Jackson at the line. Good free throw shooting. St. Cecilia, their fourth free throw. Sorry, make it 6 of 10. They've missed four. Wahoo 9 of 13. So right now, the Mern sisters, it's Maddie that's on fire. 4 from 6. She fires up another one. That's off the mark. Rebound, Walker puts it back. Missed, rebound. Goes to Schmidt, who pushes it up the floor to Farmer. Farmer, and the foul on Walker.
Hastings St. Cecilia continuing to run that floor, you know. They're looking up, here comes Farmer down. They've looked up the floor to Farmer. Farmer's taking it in. They are a running team. They like to run this floor.
First one is off. Now into the game comes Sydney Hancock. She'll go in for Aaron Walker. Sydney, 5'8" junior guard. And now the second one from Farmer is good. And back in now for St. Cecilia is Chanel Farmer. Two-point lead for Wahoo. It's showing a little press. Back to Sadie up top.
You know, we get this offense going here, and we're going to get all mixed up here, Larry. We got Burns, we got Hancocks, we got Farmers.
That's right.
Trying to keep all these sisters straight here.
Back to Sadie. Kicks it over to Hancock, dribbles into the paint, goes off the glass. Nice job of regathering and putting it off glass by Hancock. Four-point lead for Wahoo as we near the one-minute mark in the third. Good pass inside. Nice leading pass, and Lexi Schmidt with the catch and the bucket, and a timeout called by John Kyle of St. Cecilia. Well, let's go to Matt Schick. Matt.
Yeah, Lexi Schmidt, who just made the bucket for Hastings St. Cecilia. You may have noticed she's wearing pink shoes. She's the only one on the floor wearing pink shoes. She has good reason to. Her grandmother died of breast cancer just last fall, so not only is she playing for a state championship tonight, she's been playing for her late grandmother all season long. Larry.
Certainly that disease has affected so many people, and great to see the continual support and awareness for breast cancer. Stand out a little bit too, hard to miss them. Mm-hmm. 40-38, 1 minute to go here in the third. And they will come out of that huddle with some pressure, easily broken by Mern. Right back, Maddie Mern with the three, rattles out. St. Cecilia now with a chance to tie it. Shot on the way from Schmidt, got it. All even at 40. And the travel.
Yeah, they get that momentum going. They got 26.6 seconds left in the quarter. Get that momentum going here. They can go in at the end of the third quarter, maybe ahead here, and get some momentum in that last quarter of that championship game.
So 26 seconds left here in the third. All even at 40. Farmer will run it. Farmer's got it up front, holding for the last shot. 10 seconds, they'll run the offense. Jackson's got it. Tries to go around Sadie. Goes off of Sadie's foot and stays with St. Cecilia, the Hawkettes. So less than 5 seconds now. Inbounded by Farmer, back into the game. For Wahoo comes Kate O'Brien into the game. Kate O'Brien, they'll put her on the ball. Right back in the three-pointer on the way. It's off, tipped around, shot back up, no good. So no surprise, third period goes just as the first did, with Wahoo taking an early lead. St. Cecilia comes storming back to tie it at 22 at the half. Same thing happened in the third. We head to the fourth, all even at 40.
Hey, college doesn't just happen. You have to be a pain, in a good way. Find someone to help you, like a mom, a dad, a teacher, or a coach. Just keep asking until you find someone who will. There were adults in my life who helped me take the right classes in high school, apply for scholarships, and research colleges. Thanks to them, I made it to college. And so can you. You just have to ask someone for help. This is one time it's okay to be a pain.
95% of American corn farms are family-owned.
Farmers grow 70% more corn per ounce of fertilizer than just 35 years ago.
The energy to grow a bushel of corn has dropped by 37% over the past 30 years.
Farmers have cut soil erosion by 44% through new tillage methods.
This is sustaining innovation, and it's how Nebraska corn farmers are growing more with less. On the web at nebraskacorn.org.
So welcome back to the Bob Devaney Sports Center. The final period of the day headed your way. It's all even at 40 in the C1 State Championship. Want to remind you, if you'd like a DVD of this game or any of today's basketball tournament games, just log on to netnebraska.org and click on that Shop NET tab, or you can call us at 1-800-868-1868. Underway here in quarter number four.
No, we've gone three quarters, and we're still tied. It's 40-40. It's an even match here.
Great job by Chanel Farmer. Right around the pick and puts it off glass. Up by two. Walker thought about the three. Kick back out. And Mern will reset. Mern has it, back to her sisters, Sadie Mern. Back to Maddie. Bennett drives into the lane. Out to Walker, shot, Walker hits the shot, not a three. Back to even at 42. Shot put up in the lane. 2-point St. Cecilia lead. Mearn drives into the paint, dishes it back. Walker three is short. Nice job of defending that ball by Lexi Schmidt. Here's a look at that last play.
Good drive into the basket, taking it up really strong in there inside. But making that move quick, driving in, getting those inside shots.
Jackson has it taken away by Mearn. Sadie Mearn loses it. Now Mearn will try it again. Jackson now has it. Gets St. Cecilia into the front court. Nice pass in the off glass. Biggest lead of the game now for St. Cecilia, up by four. Sadie kicks it back out. Over to Maddie. Walker up front, goes down low. Good pass underneath, tipped away. What a block. Nicola got a piece of that.
Set a couple great plays. She just had the touch pass down here on the offensive end. Now a big block down here on the defensive end.
Another touch pass. And then the foul on Schmidt. So Schmidt will go to the line. Lexi Schmidt, 5'7 senior. Pink shoes and all at the line. 4-point lead. Now five. And a timeout. Full timeout called by Linda Walker. So let's go to Matt Schick. He's with a very special guest. Matt.
Yeah, up here in the stands with legendary high school coach Bob Schnitzler, the father of Wahoo coach Linda Walker, the grandfather of player Aaron Walker. How is this, watching some of your family compete for a state championship?
Well, I tell you, it's awesome to see them out there competing, and it's more scary up here than it is when you're down there coaching. But Wahoo right now is down 5 points, but I think they can come back. They've been down before, that they just have to work hard and give some easy buckets to fall.
You've won 5 girls state basketball championships. You had 18 trips to state. If you were in that huddle right now, what would you be saying to this team?
Well, I think it's time to probably put on their press. They pressed all year. It's time to make a decision and see if they can get some turnovers. And they've got about 5.5 minutes to go, so there's plenty of time on the clock.
You alluded to it, a little more nervous sitting up here than when you coached?
Yes, this is terrible, I'll tell you, sitting up here and watching the ball game. You have no control when you're up here. When you're coaching, at least you think you have control, and that's the way it goes when you're a father and a grandfather and all those kind of things.
Thanks for taking some time with us.
Okay.
Bob Schnitzler, state champion.
Larry. All right, thanks, Matt. Who doesn't love Bob Schnitzler? One of the great guys and great coaches in Nebraska high school history. At one time, he was the all-time winningest football coach in Nebraska football history, and oh, he won 5 state championships as a basketball coach as well. One shot, Sadie Mearn from downtown. That cut that lead in half, now at 3. Great drive the other way. Farmer got it. Back and forth battle here in the fourth. 4:55 to go.
It is. We got just under 5 minutes, and we are just going up and down and scoring all up and down as we go, you know, from one end to the other. Wondering if they can keep this pace up for the last 5 minutes of the game.
Great drive and the foul on Emily Brodahl. So Brodahl will go to the line, try to cut it back to a 3-point lead. Brodahl, number 33, 5'9", senior center. Brodahl has already earned a Regent scholarship. She'll be going to UNL. High praise for Emily Brodahl.
You know, Bob makes some good points. I bet it is just driving him crazy that he, you know, has to sit here and watch this. But I always thought, as a coach, you know, you can control some, but not as much as a player. Right. When I was a coach, I didn't feel as much as in control. When you're a player, you know you can do it. You know you're going to get that done. It doesn't always happen as a coach.
Inside, nice pass. And the foul down low. Foul called on Brodahl. And Schmidt really beginning to take over this game inside for St. Cecilia. She's got 12 points now. And she will go back to the line. Schmidt knocks it in.
Here it is on the inside. You know, does a good job of taking that up real strong. And as you look at St. Cecilia, they're shooting 53% from the field and 71% from the free throw line. That's some pretty good shooting for the ball game as well, just as like we saw in the last game with Seward.
Schmidt misses the second end of that. Maddie Mern three-pointer is off. Rebound again, Schmidt. Push up the floor. Rolled in there by Chanel Farmer. Largest lead of the game for St. Cecilia, it's at 8. 3:50 left. Walker on the line. Here comes the press. Sadie, great effort diving into press row. Trying to keep it alive. Timeout called by St. Cecilia.
There's that great effort by Sadie. As I said before, she is all over the floor, diving everywhere. You would never know that she just came back in district game after a sprained ankle, because you don't even see that. She doesn't even act like it, you know, anything ever happened to her before.
Enjoying the atmosphere here at the Devaney Sports Center, final state championship of the day. And a reminder again, log on to facebook.com/NET Sports and become a fan. You can leave questions, comments, see what's happening behind the scenes at NET, plus find out what's coming up next on Nebraska's Home for Sports. It's fast, fun, and easier than ever to be part of Nebraska's only statewide sports network on facebook.com/NET Sports. So John Kyle calling the timeout, seeing that Wahoo dropping into that press.
You know, we talked at the beginning of the game how Hastings St. Cecilia likes to run the floor, and as you look at it, you know, sometimes those guards on Hastings St. Cecilia, they don't even look like they're tired, and I am telling you, they have worked up and down this floor. So sometimes people say, well, maybe they're not working hard enough. They're working. They have a lot of energy in them.
Erin Walker, you saw, looked like she had a cut on her chin. You could see the blood on the uniform. She's being attended to behind the bench. So Walker out of the game. Hancock in there. And now St. Cecilia. A little more deliberate in the approach.
Yeah, gonna be a little patient now. You know, they have that lead by 8. No reason that they have to take a shot.
Foul on Sadie Mern. Third foul on Mern. One and one for Chanel Farmer. First one is good. About to make it the largest lead of the game by either team as it goes off the back of the rim. Good hustle. Maddie Mern to Sadie. Sadie with the three. Got it. Still a 6-point advantage by St. Cecilia. Kicked out, shot, Farmer, got it. What a clutch shot by Chanel Farmer.
guys really stepped up here at the end, made some huge baskets for Hastings St. Cecilia.
2:30 left in the game. Another three on the way. Off. Rebound by Maddie. Drive to the bucket. Got the roll. So now Sadie Murr really starting to warm up. Farmer again. Same spot. Why not?
That's that quick release up the court. She's there. She's got the hot hand right now. They want to get it to her.
Three in. Whew. Look out. It on the toss in, it hit the bottom of the backboard, so the ball will go to Wahoo. So on that inbounds pass, it careened off the backboard, and Wahoo keeps it. So a 5-point game. As Sadie, who moments ago had 5 points, now has 13. It's 58-53, St. Cecilia on top.
Hello, I'd like to personally thank approximately 2,000 members of the NET Sports Partners Club, and I'd like to extend a special thanks to our generous corporate underwriters who make more than 200 hours of sports programming possible for both you and me each year. Through your generosity, all Nebraskans enjoy a season ticket to dozens of games and events each year right in their own homes. Again, from all of us at NET, thank you for your support.
Well, a couple of stars beginning to shine for each of these squads. For Hastings St. Cecilia, Chanel Farmer in the fourth quarter. Chanel with 13 points. Sadie Murn in the fourth quarter for Wahoo, 11. Both of these players beginning to warm up here late in the fourth. And you see the patch job done on Aaron Walker. Looks like Aaron has put on a new jersey as well. She's now wearing number 35 as she had blood on her 23 jersey. And she's wearing the jersey of Jess Berry now.
Ladies and gentlemen, Aaron Walker,
35. The announcement being made to the fans here. Switching jersey because she had blood on her previous jersey. And John Kyle wanting clarification on exactly why that happened. No shot, foul call. Foul on Farmer. Now, St. Cecilia with just four team fouls. They have some to give. Outside Sadie, thought about it right away, guarded closely by Jackson. Now to Maddie. We'll drive into the paint. Didn't get the roll. Rebound, got a jump ball. Stays with Wahoo. 58-53, St. Cecilia. 1.5 left in the game for the C1 state championship. Ball tipped. Boy, what great hustle to get after that ball. Hancock. Travel.
You can tell we're getting down here close to the end, Larry. We got both teams just going after every single ball. Every possession is very important at this point.
Ball gets into Jackson. She breaks the press, and Jackson in for the lay-in. Missed it. Murn with the rebound. 1:15 left. Murn gets it back, and back to Murn. Murn drives into the paint. Charge. Charge called on Sadie Murn. That's her fourth.
So four fouls now on Sadie Mern.
You know, here she is driving to the basket very strong, but you know, they're standing there, they're ready for her to come in. They know she goes 100 miles an hour when she has that ball. And now they get a quick turnover.
So 1:02 left and they get the ball back. Found Sadie Mern right back up top. Closing quickly. Skip pass over to Hancock. She tries the three. That rolls out. Rebound Farmer and a foul called on the Warriors. They called it on Maddie Mern. Her third personal.
Hastings St. Cecilia doing a good job of staying calm because Wahoo's getting lots of rebounds and lots of chances at this to, you know, cut that lead that they St. Cecilia has. They have it by five right now.
So with 51 seconds left, Linda Walker will take a timeout. St. Cecilia. Well, we'd love to hear what you're thinking and let us know if you're enjoying the NSAA Girls Basketball Tournament. It's really easy. Just send us an email at sports@netnebraska.org. Your comments help NET Sports decide what programs are important to you and also helps us prepare for the best coverage possible. So please take a moment and write us at sports@netnebraska.org and let us know what you think. Right now, a lot of thinking going on in Wahoo and Hastings as these two schools just 51 seconds from a state champion being crowned. Linda Walker just had a brief conversation. What was she saying to her team, Trudy?
You know, I think right now she's still telling them to stay calm, stay settled, just like she was saying at halftime, execute. You know, don't get excited. We got 51 seconds. That's time. In these games, look how many threes they've hit. They've got time.
Therese Farmer buries it. Second free throw from Therese. 6-point lead. That's off. Still a two-possession game if they can hit two threes. Maddie Mern, three-pointer. Got it. What a big shot by Maddie Mern. Ball on the ground. A scramble for it, picked up by Farmer. And now the foul by Maddie Mern. 29 seconds left, forced to foul. And you're sending Therese Farmer, a terrific free throw shooter, to the line. Farmer 4-for-6 from the line tonight. Got it. Extends that lead to four, makes it a two-possession game again with 29 seconds left.
Big free throws here at the end, you know, to step up and just make that basket like that. You gotta have lots of confidence that game.
So now both Sadie and Maddie Mern have four fouls. John Kyle takes the timeout. With a 5-point lead. So down to the wire here in our final state championship of the day. Began this morning at 9 a.m. We've crowned five state champions already. One more here in Class C1. Along with Trudy Nolan, Matt Schick, I'm Larry Putney. Great to have you with us as we've been here throughout the day crowning state champions and bringing you this coverage from border to border across the state of Nebraska. Very easy to connect with us. You can do so at facebook.com/NET Sports. Log on and find out what's going on behind the scenes and what's coming up on NET Sports. We know next week on NET we'll have the boys' state high school basketball championships for you. That's next Saturday, all day long.
You know, John Kyle coming out of his timeout here, I'm sure he's telling them, you know who those three-point shooters are going to be for them. We need to know on the floor where they are at. And if they make it, we need to stay calm when we get the ball back in inbounds.
Mercedes got it, looking for her shot. Driven lane, kicks it back. Three-pointer by Walker, and she's fouled. Three shots by Walker on the foul of the three-point shooter. So that will send Aaron Walker to the line.
Here's that good drive by Sadie, and she kicks it out. Walker takes the quick shot there and gets the foul there.
First one on the way, got it.
Seconds. We are going down to the wire, Larry.
Second one, good. This one makes it a two-point game with 17 seconds left. Unless they can get a quick turnover off the make, they'll have to foul.
We know that pressure defense is coming right away as soon as it gets out there.
Try to get the rebound and the foul. Farmer once again.
One thing is that puts Sadie, that's her fifth foul. She does a great job of bringing the ball up the floor, you know, and looking for her sister, looking for the three herself.
You can see the emotion on Sadie's face is just realizing that she is fouled out of the game. Morgan Hancock now will go into the game. And a good round of applause by the Wahoo fans for Sadie Murn. Farmer got it. So that makes it a 4-point lead and at least a 2-possession game. Linda Walker not done coaching yet. 14 seconds, still plenty of time. Get off a quick shot. Force a turnover on the inbounds. Or get a quick foul.
Maybe they have that time, but Therese Farmer, her senior, she has done a nice job here at the end, stepping up to that free throw line and knocking them down.
Farmer 4-for-5 from the free throw line in the last minute and a half. So they've got the right person at the line for St. Cecilia. I want to say thanks to our outstanding NET Sports production crew and the job they've done throughout the entire day, getting here bright and early this morning, long before games began. This crew was out here working hard to bring you these state championship games. We're off on camera. They'll be back next week as well with all of the highlights of the boys' state basketball tournament. It's been a terrific day of girls' state championships, and we're looking forward to next week as well as the boys lock heads for state titles. Brought up the floor by Walker, tipped away, and the foul called up top. Just the sixth team foul, so no bonus yet.
Seconds. They got to look for a quick shot here and then a foul on the inbounds right away to have a chance.
Murn trying to get open, finally does, fires up, has it blocked, and a foul. So Sharice Farmer fouled, and she will head back to the line again. And Farmer has been fantastic from the line in the last minute and a half. 5 of 6, and she gets sent there once again.
You can hear the Hastings St. Cecilia. They're feeling it coming on here. 4.9 seconds. They can see the championship coming their way.
That rattles in there. And now the bench will clear for St. Cecilia. Into the game, Sarah Godert. Alyssa Schropp. And Olivia Thomas, number 22, in there as well. So a 30-second timeout called by John Kyle to talk it over with his team. 4.9 seconds left, and the inevitable, St. Cecilia about ready to win a state championship for the first time since 1982.
You know, I know in that timeout, Linda Walker is still telling him, keep after it, keep working at it, never giving up at any point in any game.
Actually, their first title since 79. They were in the championship game in 82. And so Mern will bring it up and fire away one last shot and made it at the buzzer. 65-61, Hastings St. Cecilia, state champions in Class C1. The Hawkettes' first title since 1979. Congratulations to Hastings, to St. Cecilia, and to the Hawkettes, coaches and players, on a state championship, their first in more than 30 years. When we come back, medal and trophy presentations. There's your winning coach, John Kyle. We'll chat with him as well on the other side of the break. 65-61 the final.
Programming on NET Television is provided in part by the Dr. Tom and Dorothy Hallstrom Inspire Nebraska Athletics Endowment.
Programming on NET is made possible by a gift from Harold and Marian Anderson, recognizing the importance of high school and college athletics in Nebraska.
NET Sports coverage of the 2011 NSAA State Basketball Tournament is brought to you in part by One Oak Energy Marketing, supporting 4-H and FFA in the Nebraska counties we serve. At oneoakenergymarketing.com. By the Education Quest Foundation, improving access to college through scholarships, grants, and college planning services. And by the Nebraska Public Power District, applauding the dedication, teamwork, and sportsmanship of Nebraska's high school athletes. Okay. Back at the Bob Devaney Sports Center as Hastings St. Cecilia cuts down the nets after winning its first state championship in more than 30 years, 1979, the last time they won. We have some sportsmanship awards to hand out before the medals and trophies are presented. And for that, we go to Rich Broderson.
The Nebraska Coaches Association and the Nebraska Athletic Administrators Association are proud to support the positive aspects of high school athletics. Good sportsmanship is a key factor in our philosophy. And at this time, we are pleased to present the Class C1 Sportsmanship Award. The trophies are graciously donated by Awards Unlimited and underwritten by the Nebraska Independent College Foundation. Making the presentations are Steve Board, president of the NSIAA. Presenting the trophy and representing the Nebraska Independent College Foundation is Joel Weiland, vice president of Doan College. Ladies and gentlemen, the Class C1 Sportsmanship Award winner is Wahoo High School. Receiving the award, Jason Leibel, athletic director, and seniors of Wahoo High. Congratulations, Wahoo High School. The Nebraska School Activities Association is pleased to present medals and trophies to both of these outstanding teams. The awards will be presented by NSAA Board of Control members Max Croker of Ord and Wendy Hendricks of Lincoln East. They will be assisted by U.S. Bank Representative Jeff McCune. First, here are the awards for the 2011 Class C1 runner-up from Wahoo High School.
Will head coach Linda Walker and your assistant step toward the middle of the court to present the silver medals to each member of your team. Players, as your name is called, please come forward to receive your medal. Number 11, Sydney Hancock. Number 13, Darcy Berry. Number 21, Sadie Mern. Number 41, Sam Granginet. Number 43, Caitlin O'Brien. Number 45, Lois White. And now to the seniors, number 15, Maddie Mern. Number 23, Aaron Walker. Number 25, Kayla Bennett. Number 31, Morgan Hancock. Number 33, Emily Brodahl. And number 35, Jessica Berry. All of you are welcome to receive the runner-up trophy for your school. Congratulations, Wahoo High School, 2011 Class C1 State Runner-Up. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to the champions from Hastings St. Cecilia High School. First, head coach John Kyle. We have a special coaches award for you. Congratulations. Now, coach, hand out the gold medals to your championship team members. Players, as your name is called, please come forward to receive your medal. Number 2, Libby Kissinger. Number 4, Chanel Farmer. Number 11, Sarah Gettert. Number 12, Jamie Williams. Number 14, Morgan Nicola. Number 15, Caitlin Ernst. Number 20, Alyssa Schrupp. Number 22, Olivia Thomas. And now to the seniors, number 1, Abby Jackson. Number 3, Charisse Farmer. Number 5, Lexi Schmidt. And number 10, Tessa Kalupa.
And now, all of you are welcome to receive the state championship trophy. Congratulations to the Hawkettes of Hastings St. Cecilia High School, the 2011 Class C1 State Basketball Champion.
She's not here.
So your state champions, once again, the Hastings St. Cecilia Hawkettes, finishing the season at 22-4. And what a terrific finish for this team from Hastings, who really trailed much of that game and came back every time and answered the bell, and then in the fourth period really took over.
They really did. They used that run game the whole time. And as you look at the second half, Hastings St. Cecilia field goals shot 72% in the second half. That's a huge amount of baskets to make, you know, let alone free throws. They were 16 for 20 just in the second half. That's 80% at the free throw line.
Wow.
I don't think John Kyle could ask for any more than that percent on the offensive end.
So a great performance by that St. Cecilia squad, and likewise by the Wahoo Warriors, who finished the season at 27-2, and another terrific year by Linda Walker, and another disappointing finish right here at the Devaney Sports Center. For more on that, we go to Matt Schick.
Thanks, Larry. Another disappointing finish, as he said. Where did this game turn, do you think, tonight?
I really think our first half was kind of indication that we just weren't working on all cylinders out there. And, you know, we came out second half. I thought things started to turn around for us. And then Hastings St. Cecilia just really took it at us at times. And, boy, they could not miss a shot either. Just seemed like, you know, we weren't getting any cut breaks.
That was a big part of it. And you're going to say goodbye to a lot of special seniors as well.
I am going to say goodbye to a lot of seniors. I tell you what, these girls have worked so hard. It started way back when they were young in third grade. We've been together. And, of course, their ultimate goal was to be state champs, but it just didn't happen. And give Hastings St. Cecilia credit. They played a tremendous game against us tonight, and we just didn't have enough to get the job done.
Well, a great season. Thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.
Larry?
Certainly hear the disappointment in Linda Walker's voice as she does say goodbye to some outstanding seniors like Mern and Walker and Bennett, Hancock, Brodel. So a tough loss for the Wahoo Warriors, but there are your state champs, St. Cecilia, the Hawkettes. When we come back, we'll hear from the champs from the Devaney Sports Center. Stay with us.
America's export of soybeans helps the U.S. maintain a positive agricultural trade balance. Nebraska contributes half of its soybeans for export. The protein and oil content in soybeans enhance the growing demand for higher protein diets. The Nebraska Soybean Board promotes research to develop new soybean varieties with higher protein and oil content for major agricultural markets. The Nebraska Soybean Checkoff, growing opportunity from the ground up.
Isn't worth your full attention.
What is?
A safety reminder from your Nebraska Department of Roads.
A flame burns brightly in these young Nebraskans. It's the energy of enterprise and entrepreneurship, a passion for learning and leadership, responsibility and respect. At One Oak, we see that flame, and in it we see Nebraska's future. That's why we support 4-H and FFA in the counties we serve. Because we want to keep their flame burning always. Natural gas from One Oak Energy Marketing, the one in energy.
NET Sports coverage of the 2011 NSAA State Basketball Tournament is brought to you in part by the Nebraska Corn Board and Nebraska's corn farmers. Growing more with less through sustaining innovation at nebraskacorn.org. By the Nebraska Soybean Board, encouraging the use of renewable biodiesel fuels for a healthier environment. For information, NebraskaSoybeans.org. By the Nebraska Public Power District, applauding the dedication, teamwork, and sportsmanship of Nebraska's high school athletes. And by Time Warner Cable, inspiring young people to build the skills they need in science, technology, engineering, and math to become the problem solvers of tomorrow.
Back at the Devaney Sports Center, which is slowly emptying, and St. Cecilia still celebrating their state championship in Class C1, 65-61 over the Wahoo Warriors. Let's take a look at some final statistics from this game, and what a night it was for those Farmer Girls. Farmer Girls combined for 36 points, and here's a look at the team statistics.
You know, and as you look at it, we've already talked about field goal percent. Look at that, Hastings St. Cecilia field goal percent, 55%. They got 30% at the three-point line, and as we said before, they're 80% at the free throw line. That is really good shooting on the night. We talked about it in the Seward game, how well they shot. Here comes Hastings St. Cecilia doing the same thing. But, you know, give credit. Look at Wahoo, the three-point field goals. They had 10 of 25. They shot 40% from the three-point line. Just some shots, you know, the field goal percent, they are 39%. Just didn't get some to fall when they needed them. And the momentum for Hastings St. Cecilia was going their way when they got them to fall.
So when we come back, we'll head back with Matt Schick, and he will have the champs, and we'll hear from them coming up next on NET Sports.
What inspired me to pursue a career in technology was the fact that I have kids. We need the internet. They wouldn't be able to do any of their research without it. It's really important for our children to think science and technology is important. I believe that all kids should look towards technology because that's where the world is going. Get involved in all of the science activities because all of that experience can lead you a long way.
To find out what you can do to inspire a young person, visit connectamillionminds.com.
We'd like to say we have the good life in our state. And for more than 40 years, Nebraska Public Power District has kept the good life running smoothly for Nebraskans. We are driven to go above and beyond with a spirit to provide reliable, affordable electricity with outstanding customer service each and every day. Because in the end, we want to make the good life better for all. Nebraska Public Power District, always there when you need us.
Hastings St. Cecilia, your Class C1 state champs, 65-61 over the Wahoo Warriors here with John Kyle and your 11th season. We talked about it just before we came on. You've been there a while, a long time coming, but a nice hill to climb here for you.
Oh, it's fabulous, and a fabulous feeling. We, you know, we caught fire that first night against Ashland Greenwood, a real good team there, and it seemed like our confidence just skyrocketed. And you would carry that in the Sandy Creek game last night and then again into the Wahoo game, and we're standing right here right now.
A slow start, or maybe a better said, a hot start for Wahoo, and then they cooled off. What was the difference there that allowed you guys to get back into the game?
Well, they had a real good start. They made their first three or four shots, or four out of five, and I told the girls they're not going to shoot that way the whole game. You just got to have confidence, and they cooled off a little bit, but they're a very tough team, and they kept coming at us. Even when we had a nice lead, they kept throwing punches and coming at us.
You talk about percentages. What about your team? 55% from the floor. I don't know if you guys have done that this year, but you couldn't have picked a better time to do it.
Well, we did it last night pretty well against Sandy Creek. And like I said, our confidence just went up when we played Ashland Greenwood. And with these girls, we see them in practice day in and day out. They make shots. We just say, why can't we do that in a game? And we did that these last 3 days, and then we're holding the trophy because of it.
First state championship for St. Cecilia since 1979. What does this mean to the community out there?
Oh, I think it means a great deal, not only the community and our school, but our program. And we've really built up a good program. We feel like we deserve to be down here with a great field in C1. And so, you know, it's just another statement that we're making.
Be a nice trip back to Central Nebraska. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
There he is, John Kyle. We will return with a few of the players next here at the Bob Devaney Sports Center. Hastings St. Cecilia, your Class C1 state champs.
of American corn farms are family owned.
Farmers grow 70% more corn per ounce of fertilizer than just 35 years ago.
The energy to grow a bushel of corn has dropped by 37% over the past 30 years.
Farmers have cut soil erosion by 44% through new tillage methods.
This is sustaining innovation, and it's how Nebraska corn farmers are growing more with less. On the web at nebraskacorn.org.
Students, do you know what's in demand? You are. Your knowledge, energy, and skills are all in demand. And so are many rewarding and exciting jobs in the electric utility industry. Visit bnppd.com
and talk with your teachers and guidance counselors. They can help you find the right college or university to study an energy career or the right apprentice program to gain skills and experience. Tap into your internal energy and see how far you can go.
Matt Schick back at the Bob Devaney Sports Center. Hastings St. Cecilia Hawkettes 65-61 winners for the Class C1 NSAA Girls State Basketball Championship. Abby Jackson is here, and how does this feel to end your career with a state championship? The school's first since 1979.
Well, especially as a senior, it feels amazing. We couldn't ask for a better way to end the season.
Wahoo started off pretty hot, and then you guys just met them shot for shot. It was really a slugfest there in the second half, up and down the court. What was that like to play in a game like that?
We've probably been through that situation a lot throughout the years, and I don't know, we just worked through it.
Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
All right, let's bring in the next one. As they hand off the trophy and are careful not to drop it, Cherise Farmer is here. You know, 3 of 6 from the floor, but you did your damage at the charity stripe. 10 of 12 from the free throw line down the stretch. Why were you able to knock down those free throws that were really pressure packed?
Well, I knew the free throws really counted, so all I could do is just take a deep breath, and I knew I could do it, and I just shot it.
When did it kind of hit you in this game that not only were you going to be able to hang with Wahoo, but you were going to beat that team tonight?
Well, the last minute I knew they were going to start fouling, and we had a lot of good girls that can shoot free throws, so I knew that we'd get them then.
What does it mean to be able to do this with your sister as well?
It feels really great to see her do so well and help the team in so many ways. It's just awesome to both play together, and it couldn't ask for a better way to end it.
Congratulations. I'm going to have to ask you to hand off that trophy.
Thank you.
All right. To your sister, no less, Chanel Farmer. Is that the best trophy exchange you've ever had with your sister in your life?
It was. It has been a great season and fun playing with her, especially for her last year. So it was really good to win it, and it was fun with Cherise.
9 of 14 from the floor, 20 points for you, leading the way for your squad. What got into you tonight? I know this is nothing new. You've had a great state tournament and a great season.
It was a slow start for me, and I saw some open areas, so I took it to my advantage, and luckily they went in, and it worked out really good in the end.
There were a couple of times you were dribbling down the court, and your coach was saying, okay, calm it down a little bit, slow it down, and there you go, draining a jumper a couple in the last 2.5 minutes. Were you not listening to your coach?
Well, I could hear it, but I saw the open area, and I knew it was good, and I luckily made it, so...
You went with the hot hand, your own hand.
Yes.
Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
All right, hand off that trophy one more time. Lexi Schmidt. Lexi, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
How does this feel?
It feels amazing. I think what makes it feel even better is that everybody doubted us and no one thought we could do it but us.
When do you think this game turned tonight? What was the deciding factor in your mind in this game?
I think the last couple minutes when... they had fouls on us. They knew when, if they fouled us again, we had to shoot, and that's what it came down to, is making our free throws.
And you made 5 of your 6 attempts for 13 points, and we talked about it earlier tonight, your pink shoes tonight. I know this state championship means something extra special for you.
Yeah, it does. My pink shoes represent my grandma, who died in October of breast cancer, and I think of her every time I put them on and ask her to help me.
Well, you did her proud tonight, and you know she would be. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
It's awesome. Hastings St. Cecilia, your Class C1 state champs, ends a terrific day here at the Bob Devaney Sports Center. We will put a ribbon on this one when we return next.
Hey, college doesn't just happen. You have to push yourself as you go through high school. Don't be afraid to take hard classes like Algebra 2, Biology, and a foreign language. They can help you get a better score on the ACT and prepare you for college. Now, I was no brainiac in high school, but I took the tough classes and I passed. So push yourself over to the counselor's office and sign up for them. They might not be easy, but you'll be glad you did.
A flame burns brightly in these young Nebraskans. It's the energy of enterprise and entrepreneurship. A passion for learning and leadership, responsibility and respect. At One Oak, we see that flame and in it we see Nebraska's future. That's why we support 4-H and FFA in the counties we serve, because we want to keep their flame burning always. Natural gas from One Oak Energy Marketing, the one in energy.
Okay, I just wanna be okay today.
NET Sports coverage of the 2011 NSAA State Basketball Tournament is brought to you in part by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Nebraska. One less thing to worry about. By the Nebraska Corn Board and Nebraska's corn farmers. Growing more with less through sustaining innovation at nebraskacorn.org. By One Oak Energy Marketing. Supporting 4-H and FFA in the communities we serve at oneoakenergymarketing.com. By the Nebraska Public Power District, applauding the dedication, teamwork, and sportsmanship of Nebraska's high school athletes. And by the Education Quest Foundation, improving access to college through scholarships, grants, and college planning services. So the Devaney Sports Center is emptying, and the state championships have been crowned. A total of six state champions decided today in the final one in Class C1 as the Hastings St. Cecilia Hawkettes knock off Wahoo 65-61 to win a state championship. Your first one with us. How did it go for you?
You know what? I enjoyed my day. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I thank you, Larry.
Oh, absolutely.
And Matt and NET. I don't think I could think of a better place to be than on a Saturday in March at Bob Devaney for the Girls State Championship. It was a great day of basketball and always fun to watch these girls in the state basketball. Because, again, like I said before, this is what they worked all year for, and it's good to see all the enthusiasm here in the Bob Devaney Sports Center.
Very well put. Another great day of high school championships on NET. Six more state champions go in the record books, and history is made. And don't forget, next week, the NSAA State Basketball Championships on the boys' side all day long. You can catch those exclusively right here on NET1 and NETHD. Thanks to Trudy for an outstanding job all day. Matt Schick behind the scenes doing a great job with the interviews. As humorous as he tries to be, he did a fantastic job once again. Thanks also to our entire NET Sports production crew for another outstanding job. They'll be back next week bringing you more state championships. So for Trudy Nolan, Matt Schick, and the entire NET Sports production crew, I'm Larry Putney. Good night and goodbye from Bob Devaney Sports Center.
Forsberg, inviting you to join me on the banks of the Platte River, along with a few hundred thousand of my feathered friends, the Sandhill Cranes. This wildlife spectacle doesn't happen quite like this anywhere else on the planet. And luckily, we can experience it here in the heart of the Great Plains. So I hope you'll support NET and join me for the NET Crane Excursion on Friday, April 1st.